Abandoned at birth by his father, the spawn of Praetor Rykard sought only to prove himself and his worth. A disfigured child born of snake and man, he knew not how to survive in the world, but would learn through battle.
But yes, what is happening, y'all? Welcome back. It's another lore build, and here we are with the spawn of Rykard. Now, this, of course, is supposed to be like the bastard son of the boss. Lots of fire stuff going on, lots of snake stuff. Really like the theme behind this build, so let's talk about it. Jumping on in, 150 as always, vigor at 60. Mine we got up to 27, giving us a nice healthy amount of FP for casts. Endurance is up at 28, so that we have a medium load. Strength at 30, dex at 20. You can even those out a little bit or put a little bit more in dex, a little bit more in strength. It's basically just kind of baseline weapon requirements. Intelligence is left down at base. Faith we bring up to 60, and then arcane we bring up to 15 for a spell requirement. Now, there are a couple weapons in this build that are a lot of fun. Of course, dual magma blades. Now, these things are pretty cool. They got both physical and fire, 595 AR on them, so definitely nothing to scoff at. CDC scaling, which is why we went more into strength. If you decide you like the whips more, you would instead go more into dex. But these things, obviously, they have the dual curved sword moveset, which is fantastic. A couple good things here. We have a nice jumping attack. We have a really nice running attack. And then the weapon art on this is awesome. It creates magma, and then you can follow it up for a second one. It's just a really solid interrupt potential art. It's one of those things that a lot of people don't expect, and when you catch somebody with it, you're gonna do a ton of damage. Now, I personally like running double magma blades and then a magma whip candlestick in the offhand. Instead, if you're going dex focus, I would suggest just running one magma blade and then focus on the double whips. But either of these playstyles is gonna be viable. The double whips, of course, also have a pretty spicy moveset, and I really like how there's a big focus on liquid hot magma with this build. The whips in particular, the running attack, that thing is pretty dirty. Interestingly enough, with the rolling attack, I'd actually suggest your R1. You can see how fast the rolling whip R1 comes out compared to the L1. It's just a bit faster, and sometimes that little bit is gonna be what gets a roll catch in PvP and what gets the kill. These also have a super, super fun weapon art. You can hold this down and the whip just keeps coming, baby. And anybody that is stupid enough to try and approach you while you are creating this massive, massive shower of magma will really, really take a beating. Besides that, we are working with the giant seal, of course. Now, let's talk about incantation choices, because there's a couple here. Interestingly enough, Gravelstone Seal is actually higher on the incant scaling, 282 compared to 273. However, with the Giant's Flame incantation boost, this will outperform the Gravelstone Seal at a faith of 60, specifically for Giant's Flame incantations. The Erdtree Seal, as you can see, is only 261. This gets the majority of its value going from 60 up to 80. So if you wanted to take this up to 80 and you wanted to have less focus on strength and dexterity, just making your weapons a little bit weaker, you might want to consider using the Erdtree Seal, because it's going to outscale this, and it's by a pretty significant margin at that. Frenzied Flame, it's just not going to make the mark, you know, 239, and this also not going to make the mark here, so don't worry about those. There's also the Giant's Red Blade. Personally, I'm not a fan of this compared to the Magma Whip. I think the Magma Whip's just better. I mean, the Magma Whip is literally magma, which is awesome, but this thing has a pretty decent arc. It starts up and it's just going to go through a series of attacks, but it kind of locks you in place for it. And because of that, I really prefer the Magma Whip candlestick over that as a choice. Now, obviously, with this being a build of fire, you're like, well, hey, cowboy, you know, what happens if we are up against things like magma worms or just targets that are resistant to fire? Well, I'm glad you asked, because after he was cast out by his father, he sought solace in the Dragonkin soldiers. Pale imitations of their skyborn kin, they found solace in one another. And from them, he learned the blessings of the Dragon Halberd and the Dragonscale Blade. Weapons, the opposite of the flame he was born into, capable of calling forth lightning and ice. So yes, even our offhand weapons are lore-friendly. That's right, bitches. I love this build so much. But so yeah, Dragon Halberd as well as Dragon Scale Blade. Really nice kind of offhand choices that also fit into the lore of the build. I prefer the Halberd if you're going the dex variant. Obviously, I would suggest the Dragon Scale Blade instead. Initially, these are just pure physical, but what's nice about these is that when you do the weapon art, it's going to enchant the weapons, if you have FP, with both lightning as well as ice. So now I have frozen lightning on the blade. As you can see, that's going to bump it up to 702 AR. So if you are up against the target that is fire immune, this will definitely get the job done. You're going to be seeing frostbite procs. You're obviously having the lightning damage on top of it. And it's a pretty solid weapon all around. That being said, I don't really like it in PvP just because the simplistic moveset of poke, 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 and poke. Not exactly the strongest thing to chase people down with, but that's okay. You know, these are potential offsuits for if you were doing PvE with this build. For PvP in general, we're going to be sticking with our magma stuff. Now let's talk about the fashion. First up, Rotten Duelist Helm. I mean, it has snakes all over it. He's the bastard son, half snake, half man. Obviously, we need to rock that. I went for the briar armor here, and we altered it to get rid of the cape. I felt that this kind of fit. You know, we have the briars all over. It kind of looks like something he scrounged up off the battlefield, being someone that was tossed away. Was really liking it. I wanted to have a little bit more poise because we're trading, so we went with fire prelate, both gloves and gauntlets. Also lore friendly because, you know, there's fire prelates all over. He was born in the volcanic region. I'm sure he found them there. But they also have kind of a scalish type design, which I think fits well into his snake slash dragon heritage. Moving on down, Erdtree's favor plus two is going to help us out a lot here. In fact, I think if we drop this, we go into heavy lobe. Radagon Sorceal, as I mentioned before, with any hybrid build, I think this is worth taking. And obviously, we need strength, dex, vigor, and endurance on this build. I really like the combat focus, so I went for Green Turtle Talisman. And then for our spells, I like the Godfrey icon. Majority of time, I'm going to be charging my spells, so this feels fantastic. Right here, I just go for HP over time and negate one hit, but you can really run whatever you want in the flask. If you're going very PvE focus, the mana doesn't cost anything, and fire damage boost is obviously a really safe bet. But most of the time when I'm doing fighting, I'm usually relying on my spells as a backup, and I'm focusing on the Magma Blade and the Candlestick, which I guess I could still run the Fire and the Flask, but anyway, that's beyond the point. So let's talk about the spells. For a long time now, I've said that Pyromancy's Dookie, and it's still kind of true. I mean, it's not so much that it's Dookie, it just gets outperformed by almost everything. So we only have three actual Pyromancy spells. I went through, I tested a bunch of them. These are the three that I think are the best. First, we got Catch Flame. Now, Catch Flame, it's not going to deal a ton of damage, but it is very fast. So, boom. Boom. You can do it from jumps. Boom. You can do it from rolls. Boom. It's just a quick little pop. So, it's like, you know, we're chasing somebody down. Boom. Toss out that Catch Flame. Not too bad. Now, Giant's Flame Take Thee. This is probably my favorite skill in the bunch. Now, you're going to want to mainly free aim this, but taking this and charging it is going to be quite a beefy explosion. And the thing that I've learned about this that I really like is if the explosion doesn't kill somebody, it's usually going to knock them clean on their ass. And once it does, then you run on up, and while they're getting up, it's magma time. So you knock them down with the fireball and then toss the magma all over them. Very synergistic combo, one that I'm quite fond of. Of course, Frenzied Burst, also more fire damage, and this just gives us a long range snipe. I've always been a big fan of that one. We went a little bit into Arcane just to have access to a DS Flame. You know, given the Dragonkin soldiers and all that, I figured it was another lore-friendly-ish option. And I did consider doing Theodoric's Magma, but considering we have Magma on our weapons already, I felt I'd be better off with the Fire. Besides that, we have Burn O Flame. Now, I'm going to be honest, this thing is straight trash can tier in PvP. Players will just roll through it. However, dropping this on out onto a target, something like a giant or a troll, it's going to deal a lot of damage. We're going to actually show some of that damage in a little bit. And then besides that, I like to go buff focused. So Golden Vow, of course, offsetting our Sword Seal. And then I have Black Flame for physical or Barrier of Gold if I'm up against magical. And those are just the two that I find to be, you know, the most common in situations. But obviously with this build, you could mix things up. You could go for protection from the Erdtree. You could go, not those ones. We could go Golden Lightning Fortification. We could go for the Holy Fortification. If we go down into the flame stuff a little bit, where is she at? Where is she at? There we go. We could do Flame Protect Me. Now, you're probably thinking, hey, why not Flame Grant Me Strength? Flame Grant Me Strength is fantastic. It's just going to be a 20% damage boost. But honestly, the buff just doesn't last long. It's like a 30-second buff, and for PvP, 30 seconds is like just that initial dance where you're running around with each other. So after testing, I decided to drop Flame Grant Me Strength
for PvE and for going after bosses, I think it's still worth it, but in PvP, it's just going to fall off before you really see the value of it. So those are the main spells, loadout, the gear, all that stuff. We're going to jump on over, we're going to go visit my favorite trolls and show y'all the kind of damage things can do. Just to talk about some other pyromancy spells briefly as well, because I know I said that most of them are dookie. Let's take a look at them. So, O-Flame, this thing is terrible. It takes way too long to come out. It's a bigger version of Catch Flame, but it's just too damn slow. Flame Sling is just garbage. Giant's Flame is going to be way better. I know this is cheaper, but it's just really not worth it. Flame Fall Upon Them is decent if you need AoE clear. But the thing is, if you need AoE clear, you could just charge up a Giant's Flame, and that's going to get the job done. So, this one's kind of fun, but I found it to be less effective in PvP, and then in PvE, we could always use this. Flame of the Fell God is straight garbage here. This thing belongs in the dumpster. It is probably the most disappointing spell in the game, especially given the fact that it's a legendary incantation. Somebody has to literally fall asleep on the battlefield for this thing to hit them. Surge O-Flame, it's nice to tickle people with, but that's about it. You might pop somebody's bubble with it, but you're not getting kills with this thing. And then Whirl O-Flame is actually a lot of fun, and this has some minor tracking to it, but the big problem with this is only going to really be useful when you are fighting something in a narrow corridor. You know, if somebody's chasing you up a set of stairs, this is going to be great. If somebody is fighting you in a tight hallway, this has potential to be great. But it's a very situational in its usage, and because of that, I don't like that in my general kit. Like I said, Burn O-Flame is garbage can in PvP, but this, on the other hand, it can do massive, massive damage in PvE and on bosses, which is the main reason I've decided to keep that and include it in the build. So let's go on over. We'll go see the trolls just to kind of give you an idea of the damage some of this stuff is capable of doing. The trolls have become my favorite testing spot. Because some of this stuff, you know, I just need stuff that has a bigger health pool. So Catch Flame, pretty straightforward. Just, And you can see 520 for how fast it's coming out. And you can spam it. That's pretty good. And you catch somebody unaware. Burn. That's going to rack up. Giant's Flame, throwing out the normal. You can see 957 on that. Obviously paused the stagger, but this guy was already kind of messed up. Charging it. All right, well, that was not accurate. It doesn't always do 3,000 damage. Let me do another one here. So 1320. So not too bad. We're seeing that 30% on the charge. And obviously the range hits a lot higher. Frenzy Burst. Y'all already know Frenzy Burst. This is just, you know, it hits people. It does a good job. Aegil's Flame. Y'all already know Aegil's Flame. Obviously, this is going to do a good job. You catch somebody in this, they're going to get torched. And that's really nice for runners in general. You know, that's why I have that on top of Frenzy Burst. Next, we're going to try and sneak up behind this guy. Sneak up, hit him with that Burn O-Flame. Now, like I said, this is all about whether or not you can get this off. It's one of those things where it's like, while the boss is distracted, you're going to throw this on out. So 4,700 damage, and that was the charge cast. Even the quick one, you know, throw it on out. And you can see, I mean, we probably would have done 3,000 damage or so there if we had had more time. But so the damage is definitely there on certain stuff. It's just the PvP potential is sadly kind of lackluster. Let's show y'all these things. These things are fun. They are really fun. They are deceptively strong. You would think like, well, I mean, curved swords without bleed, you know, is it really that good? Yeah, man, they hurt. Magma time! See all that magma just burning away. This one might be a little bit harder to get off. I need to get him to go, like, try and attack and not stop if I'm gonna actually do this. Woo! Yes. This one's more jokey. So, I mean, it does get interrupted pretty easily, but man, if you have the opening, you just go to town with it. It's a really fun one. I know I don't really point out where items are anymore, because it's all on the wiki, but this one, I know a lot of people don't have this. This is from Patch's questline, in the volcano manor. You complete it and he gives you this. So definitely probably the hardest thing on this build to get. But otherwise, I mean, everything here is pretty easy to come by. You're gonna have to farm up like the pants and the gloves and whatnot, but definitely a very fun themed build. And honestly, now that we've kind of covered everything, you know, we've done, you know, basically all of the bases, if you will, I think moving forward, I'm going to be doing a lot of stuff like this. You know, I'm probably going to make a God Slayer build. I'm probably going to try and do a couple other ones, but you know, themed builds like this, especially if I can make them lore friendly, that's a lot of fun to me. So, we got some PvP. The whole thing is in the volcanic region because it's a theme build. So stay tuned. Let me know what y'all think.
You dare attack my host. Feel the wrath of the magma! Pinched in a corner, you will burn to your death.
Which one you want?
I will take the discount arcane build.
Something. Spam yours.
Well, keep spamming that. One's dead. You want me to finish this one off?
There. If you want to take it, you can.
Yeah, I'll finish off Millennium Man.
On a boy, go for them all. I'm gonna run.
He is gonna run. Come on, buddy. Scream in pain. As the flames sear thy flesh. Is it just gonna ignore me and run for you? Oh my god.
He's gonna run up and immediately kill me.
What you get? Burn in the flames of Mount Gelmir. My turn for a weapon on magma! Scream that the fires burn away your sins. Mage? Wow. Dude had no health.
77 health?
Yeah. Jebaited. Oh, was that other one like another 500 health mage?
Enough area of gold here. It's the same dude.
Oh.
All right, go fuck him up.
Whip it good. Scream and burn! Wilhelm.
Oh, we are just Whiff City right now.
Magma!
Wilhelm learned the hard way to not stand in the whip.
It's the first time I've seen someone actively just walk into that.
That's pretty bad.
I will take this man. Coming into my domain of fire.
Using a twin blade.
I can also buff. As you burn, I will show you the true power of my build, Shinus Maximus. Oh, I got stuck on the bridge.
Yeah, that lip there is a little buggy.
You have honor for an invader.
Millennia boy.
We've been through this.
How many times we gotta teach you this lesson, old man?
Unbelievable. Filthy creature,